What is mastery? Would we like a scam mastery pack? Not particularly. Would we like scam Quintorius? No?
What are you doing?
Why are these just different pictures of Zamone? What the fuck is going on in here? What is this creepy ass, like, what is that called? The nursery? This is like nursery music. Like, I expect to look up and, what is that? Oh my god, there are all these baby terms. What is that? The children, like, babies look up at from the crib to keep them occupied? A mobile. Yeah. That's what I'm getting, like, that. This is sun. No, not the sun, Six Sock. Good call. When I put my baby in its crib outside in the desert, it stares up at the sun as it slowly dehydrates. Nice. Anyways, yeah, some creepy ass music is where I was going with this. Alright, pack one, pick one. Professor of Symbology is excellent, but Wandering Alcoholic is even better than Professor. Is the dog got trample? They both get trample. Trample's part of the trick, Flipper. It's not part of the base creature. Dog doesn't have trample. The trick has trample. So whichever creature I block, he's going to cast the trick on, because that's the point of having that. Exactly, it doesn't matter. Exactly. Alright. I'm actually not sure what the game thinks about, or what... Where's Wandering Alcoholic? Wandering Alcoholic is... Actually, not that high of a win rate, actually 57%, but staying colorless instead of committing on pack one's gotta be better than just grabbing the 2-1. Anyway. All right, what next? Pilgrim, Rip Apart, Pledge Mage. Introduction to Annihilation. I like Pilgrim just fine, although it's just underperformed for us the last couple decks we played it. I like Rip Apart just fine. It's not great, it's not terrible. I like Introduction just fine. I think I'm gonna take first Rip Apart and see.
Okay.
Thank you, Zarda, for the resub.
Yeah. Didn't realize it had run out. Always good content. Cheers.
Swords to Plowshares in white. Pick three, not taken yet. That's crazy. I don't know what was in this pack. It must have been godlike. It's also a Killian. This card does a lot of hidden work. It's hard to see sometimes what it's doing because it prevents your opponent. It just reduces the number of options your opponent has, and it's super good versus the meta decks right now, which are all the fucking leyline decks. So, and it's colorless, right? You play it in everyone. You're not super excited about a 5-mana 4/4, but it's not here because it's a 5-mana 4/4. It's here because it's a 5-mana 4/4 with all the good stuff. So Rise, Quintorius in a heated debate. I think I'm taking first heated debate over first Rise. It's a little tough. Rise is just a bit slow is all. Thing is, I wasn't really sure I was red till this pick, and maybe I'm not red yet in this pick. It could be Jeskai still, for example. The Ellison, there's no, I don't have to resist Quintorius. Quintorius has lost all appeal already. So that's interesting. Guiding Voice is really solid. And it's really solid in a white-red deck. It's really solid in pretty much everything here. Creative Outburst is the Jeskai card, but it's not a super exciting Jeskai card, especially if we're trying to play Swords and Rip Apart. I think this is Guiding Voice. But we'll see. I don't know what we're playing quite yet. There's Scamtorius. There's a Spirit Summoning, a Silver Quill Pledge Mage, which tends to be a lot better in the black-white decks than the red-white decks. A Pilgrim and an Eager First Year. No reason to think this card's any good in my deck. I think this is first Pilgrim over first Spirit Summoning, but we'll see. I don't really like Spirit Summoning. I think it's one of the weaker lessons. Rarely do I want a 3/2 ground creature with no stats for three, for, or no keywords for three. These are all good cards, which is nice. I do hate that impact one. I don't feel like red white has so much flexibility in terms of the rares they can fit in. It's one of the things that's really, really nice about the Simic core decks or the spell heavy decks is you tend to have a lot of options for what you can include in that deck, those decks. Introduction to Prophecy, Show of Confidence, and Eager First Year. I like Show of Confidence. It's particularly good with first strikers, of which we tend to have a lot in this deck, although we may not get there. Could take the red-blue dual land too. That's tough. I do want things like Eager First Years in these decks. I think I'm going to grab my first year over the campus with a Show of Confidence. If we're going aggro, this card is excellent for us. Take Introduction to Annihilation over Pledge Mage or Defend. Delete Field Trip. Reflective Golem is great. It's a very late curve. We're nowhere near it, unfortunately. But, I mean, we're not that far away from it, honestly. Have these two white picks that we don't care about. I think this is Golem. Campus Guide, Spirit, Red White Duel. Second Introduction, also very late. Doesn't look like this table values lessons very highly, which is kind of crazy. I think Relic Sloth is a total and complete trash card. Does nothing. The ground tends to be fairly busy in this format, so Menace doesn't get you super far, and Vigilant Menace isn't really what you care about on your red-white finisher, like top of your curve. You want it to do something a bit more impactful than that. It's a late study break up against Mentor, Campus for black-white or red-white, and a study break. We'll take the study break. I don't mind these 3-3 mentors. They're actually fairly playable. Rise Wield. Okay. Letter of Acceptance versus Creative Outburst. That's a last pick, Creative Outburst or Wormhole Serpent. What, how? It's the same. I don't know, man. This is why you, this is, dude, your first year we kind of want. I don't really like Spirit Summoning. I guess I take the first year over the Spirit Summoning. This is why all your opponent's decks are so good at high levels of Mythic, right? It's because you're playing against people who know how to draft, who have drafted against a bunch of people who don't know how to draft. These are not exciting picks. It doesn't tend to be a lot of evasive creatures in white-red, which means Orator loses a lot of value. So Historian in red, Make Your Mark, an Academic Dispute, and a Thunderous Orator, and a Pledge Mage. I still think I'm taking the Orator. Maybe the Anatomy is better than the Orator. Card is great, but we need some evasive creatures. I guess there's a chance this is only pack two. We might pick up some like Combat Professors or other things. This pack is just Pilgrim and Environmental Sciences. I'll take the Environmental Sciences, hope to wield the Pilgrim. It's a Serpentine Curve for blue, Mortality Spear for any of the control-y decks, Professor for the green decks. Is there any world which we're not white right now, or not red right now? What would be our second color if we weren't playing red? Like splashing red only? I think we should be open to that idea though. So let's pay attention with that. There's that Combat Professor I was looking for in white. So still no decisions there, but we should be aware of the fact that we're not necessarily red. We could just be splashing red. This is the second pack, right? Second packs tends to be not super helpful for choosing your color. Sometimes it is, but I mean, it might get you there, but the point being that you're not likely to see the same colors coming to you from your second and third packs. It's supposed to be first and third pack has a bit more similarity as people figure out or people pick their colors, but we'll see. Mardu Calling, maybe. I haven't found much success in white-black splashing red. Here's interesting. That second Orator is pretty late. it's a valuable card if we can get the triggers for it, but Pledge Mage is one of those types of things that trigger, and there's also a Study Break. I will take Second Orator, but if we end up white-red, just like white-red, then it's not super exciting. There's another Study Break, a Show of Confidence, a Pigment Storm, and a Shock. I'll take the Shock. It's a push towards red, annoyingly. Well, we have one Combat Professor now. This tends to be a high priority removal target. You just want a bunch of keyword cards with this card. Like Killians and Lifelinkers and Flyers and that kind of shit. We'll see. Seem to be white splashing red. We have more white cards than red cards, that's for sure. I mean, not even that. I mean, outside of these Orators that we just picked in this pack and the Combat Professor, we're not much of any color, honestly. It's another pretty decent card for us. I think it's better than Spectre for us. Better than Introduction, better than Show of Confidence. Okay. But anytime you're just running into your opponents with these unbelievably good decks, not just drawing well, but just like card quality being insane, you should blame your tables for wheeling everything good to them. I don't really want Second Pilgrim in an aggro white-red deck that has a bunch of Orators, but what the hell else am I picking? Vigilant Menace are not keywords I want on five for my Orator, who's already vigilant and doesn't, you know, as a 2/2. The blue is no way near us. Teach by Example is no way near us. It's literally the only card in the pack for us that matters, so we're going to take it. Make your mark versus a Pigment Storm, pushing us further down red path. Still be that, or like the Spectre of the Fens. We still could end up black here. The Flyer certainly has way more value with the Orators. But Pigment Storm is fine, and our red is not... Like, the problem with, like, Heated Debate and Rip Apart and Shock is you want to cast those when they're the appropriate targets on the board, not just randomly, right? Pledge Mage, Flying is nice. Academic Dispute as Force Blocking is nice, as well as another source of Learn. I think I'll take the Dispute. I will miss that Pledge Mage in this deck, though. I don't know about Third Pilgrim right now. I'm going to take it, but we'll see. So we have two drop creatures that die, three drop creatures that die. We'll see. Spirit Summoning. Very late. We just picked up a Learn card. It's not terrible to see. Feel like a kind of mid-range red-white aggro deck. Study Break again. It's my second or third? Second. It's kind of nice. Better than Hall Monitor. Hall Monitor is basically unplayable. Third Study Break versus Show of Confidence. I like Show of Confidence, but it's better with First Strikers. It's not super exciting with a deck like this. I think I'm grabbing third Study Break. I don't mind three Study Breaks, but I want more spell triggers than just the first years for that. More Magecraft, I guess. Yeah, shocking that the Sloth's wheeled. I don't understand. All right, let's see what pack three is. Pugilist in green, Arch in green, Closing Statement in black, white, Heated Debate in red, Rise in white, black, and Guiding Voice in white. This is probably second Heated Debate for us. Over second Rise, over second Guiding Voice. Hope to wheel the Guiding Voice. It'd be nice to get like a Radiant Scroll Wielder in this deck, or possibly a third Heated Debate is fine. It's better than Scantorius. We're nowhere near Cody deck. We're a little light on creatures right now again. All right, I mean, we've got three pilgrims. Every once in a great while, we'll get some value off Quintorius into pilgrim, but that's not an aggro line. It's not a line that makes sense with the cards we have. Like, if we wheel it, we might play it. We'll see. Be nice to see another combat professor. Elemental Summoning, second Pigment Storm, first Pillar Drop Rescuer. Rescuer actually decent in this deck. We have two drops that die and a bunch of Oratories that want the flying and a show of confidence. I think I take Elemental Summoning here. Hope to wheel either the Pigment Storm or the Rescuer. It's a Rutha, but we're pretty far from being able to make that work. This pack is ridiculous. This is pick four of the final pack, so everyone knows their colors. Why is Mage Hunter's Onslaught Barry and Rutha here? It doesn't make sense. Also Hunt, Lash. Is there ever a world in which this card is good for us? This card has been really bad for me. I mean, Rutha fits in a deck like this. I have no ability to splash it though, so. Oh man, I'm still gonna grab it. It fits so well with the Heated Debates. Inkling Summoning in white is pretty solid for us. It's another Barry, pick five again, Barry. I'd love to wheel that Campus. It probably won't wheel. I'll play Divine Gambit sometimes. Here I'd love to take that Prismari Campus, but I'm gonna take Inkling Summoning. A lot of the time we don't get to play Rutha, but some of the time we do. Some of the time we get to play Rutha in this deck, so we'll see. I do have Sciences for Rutha, for sure. Second Elemental Summoning, Mage Hunter's Onslaught, Trudge and colors we're not playing. Dust Speaker is a card that we're not playing. It's too bad the Mage Summoning is here. I could run the Campus, which is really bad for our deck. Can we play Gift of Estates, I wonder? I'm gonna grab it here. I haven't played it yet. This card goes a lot better with something like that white-red card that lets me bin cards from my hand. Another Rutha. There's a Make Your Mark here. Make Your Mark's okay with this deck. I think it's better than Spirit. Better than Second Rutha. Thrill goes nicely with Gift. Do we want a Thrill? Might have been Thrill. Take a second Enthusiastic Study over a second Pigment Storm. What Gift Estates do if you have more lands than your opponent? Nothing? Correct. Guiding Voice Wield, hell yeah. Grab that. These Orators look so bad in this deck. Sounds pretty bad. It's not pretty bad. It's bad as a top deck when you're ahead in lands. So if you're already flooding and you top deck Gift of Estates, it's pretty bad. Otherwise, it's 3-for-1, right? You just play it before you play land drop, cast it, get 3 planes to hand. Red-white duel, not terrible. Lorehold Historian, not terrible. I don't know about a historian. Let's grab the Campus. Beaming Defiance, Pigment Storm. Ah, dude, man, our deck is a lot of removal, a lot of damage-based removal. It doesn't really feel good enough. Misk Rescuer on the wheel, too. Not sure what they took over that. Divine Gambit wheeled. So I would have liked to have wheeled second Rescuer, or one of those Rescuers, rather. I don't understand Brackish Trudge last pick. It's annoying. All right. So the biggest scam here were the Orators, honestly, who generally perform way better in white-black anyways, but we got particularly punished here. Spirit Summoning in the sideboard makes them a little bit better. Always playing this Professor, we're always playing all three Heated Debates and both Enthusiastic Studies and the Guiding Voices. Always playing both First Years, at least two Pilgrims. Always playing Golem in this deck. did not wheel any of the Prismari campuses, unfortunately, so we have to run islands. We're running Rutha. We can run islands. This is always shock. This is always swords. Eight cards out if we're running 17 lands. With pilgrims and if we run gift estates and seven, I mean, we don't have to run this many lands. I think I just have to have the two drops, so I think it's irrelevant. The Orators are basically 2/2 vigilant creatures. I'm looking at this deck and really wondering how I kill anyone. It's gonna have to be sideboard value because our creatures are not particularly good creatures for killing people. Always run Rip Apart, always run Make Your Mark in this deck. Probably running two Study Breaks, I need Learn. That's 38 cards in this deck, it's super unexciting. Let's go down a mountain. Can we add an island? Like Rutha gives us a shit ton of value. Oh yeah, Wandering Alcoholic's always in this deck. Rise is always in this deck. Yeah, our last cards are kind of hard here. Because we would like to play Rutha, Pigment Storms, Dispute, Last Pilgrim, Last Study Break, Gift of Estates. I like to play all those. And this is with 16 lands right now. Coach is pretty bad, so is the pupil. Nine creatures here. I don't think we can run Pigment Storms. I think they're too slow. Not sure we can run Academic Dispute. Academic Dispute is kind of a creature. We have a Spirit Summoning and an Inkling Summoning and an Elemental Summoning in sideboard, so we do want to learn early.
Have returned.
Hey, Dingo Bingo. Thanks for 12 months. Sloth gives two keywords to Orator. It doesn't. Orator already has Vigilance. Sloth gives only Menace, which is a pretty bad combo. I fully recovered. I'm not fully recovered, but I'm a lot better today than I was yesterday. Could be third pilgrim. Kind of looking at Academic Dispute. I could cut Make Your Mark. We have enough removal that we don't have to trade. It's just cards that are like Orator in first year where they don't have any way to protect themselves and want to attack a lot. Makes Make Your Mark a lot better. Our learn is Guiding Voice, double Study Break, double Enthusiastic Study, Rise. Do we just Rutha here? What spells are we Ruthing? Guiding Voice, Swords to Plowshares, Shock, Make Your Mark, Study Break, Rip Apart, Enthusiastic Study, Heated Debate. And then we double like half those spells. It's like every spell in our deck is a cheap instant or interactive spell. Oh, also all three of our summonings from sideboard. Is there anything else we could cut? Doesn't really look like it. All right. The weakest card in our deck is Make Your Mark.
You have returned.
Thank you, Jamor, for the 21 months. I wonder if this should be Academic Dispute instead of Make Your Mark. It's one more learn. One more learn gets Rutha online. Again, just our creatures are so bad though, right? None of our creatures stay alive and we don't have a high creature count. So part of me is like, Make Your Mark is essentially a creature. You can't look at these cards in isolation, Shug. Is Academic Dispute better than Make Your Mark on average in a random deck? Sure. Is it better here? I'm not so sure. It seems less likely to be better. It's definitely less likely here than a random deck. But the question is it better here? I mean, digging deep with Dispute is always nice, so cloning it off Rutha or cloning it off the Golem is great. I see a large percentage of the time where we have no fucking cards, no creatures, because we can't keep them on the board because our creatures die. Dispute is only a one mana learn. I mean, that's what that is in this deck. It's rare that we're going to get a good trade from Dispute. I think it's one or the other, pretty similar. And we were a little light on red sources. The other issue with Dispute, since it is a red spell, we're on 7 red sources right now, 2 of which are tapped. Can we go down to Plains? We need early Plains, don't we? I don't need 10 Plains, though. This could probably be 9, go up a mountain. So that's 9 red, 8, or 9 white, 8 red. Pilgrim for tutoring, more Plains. This is probably okay. This is 16 lands. All right. There's probably a joke with the wandering alcoholic and still and like no longer being dry. Probably like off, what is it? Off the wagon. The euphemism for drinking again. All right, speaking of drinking, I'm gonna go get my coffee. Back in a second. Going second, missing red sources, but we have 2 drops into 3 drops. Don't think we have a choice. Alright, missing third land. He's got removal for our first creature. It's kind of a bummer. Very nice to run out fucking Guiding Voice. There's third land, I guess. Into fourth land. Okay. That's fun, Joe. Alright. All right, I hate using environmental sciences on a mountain here, but we need it. Ah, funny game, funny game. All right, so now Ruth is a dead draw for us. Never blocks that, right? Definitely not the most mana efficient play. I could have played Plains for the option of study breaking end step. I would have liked to have left Plains open here. Played the second mountain for the thought of elemental summoning, but I guess there's no reason I couldn't have done that. I just took 5 lifelink damage for no reason here, so that's pretty unpleasant. Yeah, it's kind of a bad trade too, but getting that card off the table is fine for me too. Bin for a land. Okay. Glad class above. Guess he's recurring the Pilgrim, sure. I'm not gonna leave mana open here, I need value. Alright, let's start by tapping these two. We're gonna We're gonna pull a flyer. Is it better than a random card? Not sure. A lot of heuristics here, assuming the flyer is going to be more useful than the 3-2. And the 3-2 might actually be the difference between lethal or not if he removes that 4-4. Introduction to deal with another blocker. Didn't immediately I assume he has his own study break here. It's the only thing that makes sense. Yeah. Here we're just doing silly amounts of flooding on 16 lands again. We've already binned one. About to bin. I have to remove this 4/5. I think this is all the planes out of my deck too. Like, I think Pilgrim literally can't tutor another planes, but we'll see. Had a lot of learn value, but we're still just super flooded, right? Is the problem. So he's dead here, he always takes two. We get trample. That's probably a good draw for us then. I wonder if it makes a difference if I played on the other one or not. Anyway. We almost ran out of gas there. If we had even a little tiny bit less learn, we would have died there 100% of the time. Just so flooded for a 16 land hand. It's kind of crazy. I won't block this round, like, to get my value without Lash screwing me. Awkward though. Need 3 open mana for that. Combat Professor seems reasonable. Just can't decide how tempo heavy we are right now. Fucking annoying card right now, isn't it? All right, guess I'll lose my guiding voice. Fantastic. Prick. I still think he has Lash, right? Like, his attacks have made a lot of sense with post-combat Lash. Introduction to Annihilation. He can indestructible trick and pay it, which would suck. Other than that, seems fine. Look at Alcoholic just being a beast here. It's like, do I want to play tricks? Do I want to cast spells? All my spells suck because they cost three. I mean, to be fair, we have him on Lash this entire game. It could also be the combat, the invulnerable trick. But the invulnerable trick is better blocks, right? I guess not, because he knows he has the heated debate. That's fine. Okay. Wandering Alcoholic clone spells. I accept. So we go resolve. Copy. Kill the guy that gives him a draw but now doesn't. So it gives him one. It's fine. Take our draw. Hey, Gelfia. Thanks, buddy.
Legal baby,
indeed. I think here we just heated debate as 2-1 now. Nice top deck. We go Guiding Voice here. Pay 2. Guiding Voice there. We'll take Summoning. And Annihilation. Okay. I mean, our hand was fine without that top deck, but that top deck was really nice right there. We were at 31 yesterday, Galvia, when we after our first game of the day. 31st. We're down to 300th or something after yesterday. So, better days. So I'm pretty sure Alcoholic just screwed up his entire game plan there, which was kind of nice. He can't be too excited about annihilating my 4-4, giving me a card, then losing his creature that he's invested the token on without getting the card vantage from that, and then getting beat for a million damage the turn after. We need some more goals in this format now. I don't know, top 31 was kind of like enough for me, almost. I'm kind of at the point like I'm enjoying drafting this still, but like what else are we doing here? Do we maybe do some mixed days, some magic, some other games? Chat drafting? Doesn't sound very fun. New formats are like every 3 months, so we get a while. Go for number one. It's just like winning a fucking tournament going for number one, right? Like, they're so... Maybe it's less so. Like, I prefer the ladder system overall to the... going second with double tap lands. We have all our colors and two drops. How was I trying to say this? I prefer the RNG there. It's bad and it's annoying, but like it's whatever. So I think this is just Orator and Orator matchmaking. Thank you. Going second here, it's really unlikely we get to block, or if the block, if he does offer the trade, it's very unlikely that it's a profitable block. Unless he just randomly casts spells before combat. That's a very nice top deck. Big tempo swing for us. I can even do it while developing our tap land. Which seems good enough. First year is more valuable than Orator? No. Orator is just more exciting to have on the board in a format where I'm very likely to be racing. I wonder if I should have blocked there. Well, first things first, let's attack. All right, next, I think we're playing Environmental Sciences, Island, first year. So Vigilant is really important when you're racing someone like this. All of his open mana is now a pain in my ass. Clunky on 5 mana. The problem is not a lot of my plays are good here, right? I can't rise till next turn. He's left mana open because he's going to do something. I'd like to have Heated Debate left over when I play Rutha, but it's 7. It's 8 to do that same turn, so we're a million miles from that. So really, it's Rutha. I mean, there's a very high probability that what ends up being happening here is that I end up Heated Debating this turn and wasting 2 mana. Attacks are weird here too, with all that open mana. I think I am attacking. I'm trying to decide if I attack with the first year or not. I think it's just Orator though. Like, the first year trigger is relevant here. Oh, it's just Study Break. Well, that makes my life easy. Okay. Inkling Summoning. Okay. I think a fair chunk of the time Rutha dies, but we'll find out. Into an Umbral Juke. That's a very aggro hand over there then. Maybe it was better to play around the tap mana. Here, combat tricks are scary. Trying to maybe get too much value out of Heated Debate. I mean, that seems like an obvious no-go. Fucking Ruth on the board, opponent. Like, what are you expecting? Nice draw, actually. I should have done it on attack, I guess. Maybe not. Maybe we get two more life if we don't. Flyer or introduction? Probably introduction so I don't fucking die. Alright. Guess we can get them both. Dude, fuck off. Kind of bad news. It's a very tight game. I think we're still alive. No, we're 1 minute off. Fuck. Can't even cast. I can't survive then. Right. I can. Man. That sucks. Already played land. So we're dead here. I wonder if there was a different play. So I'm trying to think which turn it would have been. The turn where I could have attacked with Dispute to force the block would leave him at 3 higher life. There'd be 1 less poet. Maybe it was too greedy there. The thought was ambush the poet, make him pay the 4 life so he would go down and then we'd kill him on the backswing. But it might have been too greedy here. Can get inkling, but getting inkling doesn't do anything here. And it's the same mana, right, as Rutha. So like if I got inkling with Academic Dispute and then tried to annihilate, maybe I guess we're okay there because I don't have to have the dispute then. But anyways, copy inkling, we can't, chat, can we count the mana? How the fuck would I copy inkling when it cost me a mana to get the inkling? Yes, go on. Tell me the rest of the play where I have this extra mana popping out of my ass. Like maybe not playing Rutha here, like, but then I can't do anything. I have to have mana to annihilate too. Yeah. He can't pay for both flyers. Oh, that's a bitch. He's at 4. Oh no. Oh no. All right. Yeah, I can't pay for both flyers. That feels bad. Oh no. All right, the concede was too early. That's a punt. Thinking through my other plays, should be thinking on the board. That's definitely a punt, that concede. All right. So what then? I guess it would have just been passed there, huh? Hope he doesn't have removal. Eat one of the 2/1 flyers, go to... Eat the 2/1 flyer, go to 2. Or wouldn't it probably still be at 4. Depends if he has the removal. There's actually a fair number of times we stabilize there. God damn it. That sucks. Shooting down the shit plays, but not thinking about the actual plays that mattered there. Making my own shit plays. Marker it, sure. Sketchy keep. Got a 2-drop and interaction. Any red mana unlocks 2 cards. Got a fair number of red sources in our deck, but it's still painful. Yep. unnecessary concede scam for sure. Perfect draw. Hope we need to do 4 damage to something and we get a red mana to do it. Oh, it takes a turn off. I like it. A heuristic might be even worse. We lose damage, so generally the orator is more valuable, but we lose 1 damage. Was maybe worth a second more consideration. So would he be dead here? Yeah, he'd be dead. Oh, he's dead anyways. This is already 5. All right, easiest game of my life. All we had to do was draw the right cards off the top. Mountain on turn 4 into Plains to play our guy into Pump Spell. Easy life. That's skill. You guys on top deck like that? What's wrong with you? Get better. Train harder. Okay. 96% yes. Okay. Can we be Gandalf next draft? Secretly, we're always Gandalf deep down inside. I thought we missed lethal by 1 there for not leaving the thing around. I don't know. I mean, he forced the decision before we saw what he played. And we weren't close to lethal with our hand, but it was 1 more damage. It was worth consideration. The Orator not being blanked by fractals is nice in that matchup, but empty board, the eager first year is better. All right, easy gems, wandering alcoholic, carries. What do we get? 8 packs, okay. What is mastery? Would we like a scam mastery pack? Not particularly. Would we like scam Quintorius? No. Wait, why are these just different pictures of Zamone? What the fuck is going on in here? What is this creepy ass, like, what is that called? The nursery? This is like nursery music. Like, I expect to look up and... what is that? Oh my god, there are all these baby terms. What is that thing called with the... it looks like... it's like a... it's not called a carousel. The children, like babies, look up at from the crib to keep them occupied. A mobile. Yeah. That's what I'm getting, like that... this is sun. No, not the sun, Six Sock. Good call. When I put my baby in its crib outside in the desert, it stares up at the sun as it slowly dehydrates. Nice. Anyways, yeah, some creepy-ass music is where I was going with this.